Hello everyone! In this video, we'll learn how to translate and review content in SDL Online Editor, which is one of the most important features added in WorldServer 11.2. We'll go through several scenarios using two personas, a translator and a reviewer, and we'll use this file as our source asset. As a translator, the process starts when a task is assigned to me. I go to the Projects page, I click that task, and then I claim it. To open the asset and start working on it, I need to click Edit Translate on the ribbon, and then click in SDL Online Editor. Keep in mind that you can open assets in SDL Online Editor only in certain workflow steps that are configured by your administrator. Also, depending on your WorldServer user permissions, you may not have access to all the features available in SDL Online Editor. So, the asset is opened in SDL Online Editor, and we already have a lot of matches from our translation memory. That's great. It means that we can start translating. After you translate each segment, you can confirm it and move to the next unconfirmed segment by pressing Ctrl and Enter at the same time. You'll see that SDL Online Editor has a lot of shortcuts that you can use to improve your productivity, but you can find out more about them in the documentation. Okay, for the untranslated segments, you can check and see if you have any matches in the translation memory. To do so, click the View tab and then click Show Lookups. The available matches are displayed in the Lookups pane. These matches are from the WorldServer translation memory configured for your project. This match seems pretty good, so we double-click it here and replace SDL Trado Studio with WorldServer. As you go through the translated content, you can spot segments that were not segmented properly and that should be split. In this case, you select such a segment, you click Segment Actions, and then click Edit Source. Place the cursor right where you want to split the segment, and then click Segment Actions and Split Segment. Because the segment has already been translated, you can cut its corresponding translation and paste it in its proper place. You can also merge the two segments back if needed. Alright, now that you've finished translating the asset, you close it, and then you complete this step. The next step in the workflow is Save Online Asset, which means that the asset is being saved and converted to WorldServer, so that you can perform other steps in Browser Workbench or in various external tools. Now let's move on to the part for reviewers. I changed the account to Video Reviewer. The asset is in the Review step, and our administrator configured the workflow so that we can also perform the review in SDL Online Editor. For the final part, we want to review the actual translation. Let's add a comment, for instance. To do this, click the Review tab, and then click Show Comments. Now, you can add comments on one of three levels: to a selection, to a segment, or to the entire file. In this case, let's add a comment to a selection. You select the text to which you want to add a comment, you place your cursor in the comments box, and then you start typing your comment. You then specify that the comment applies only to this selection, and that it's not extremely important, and you add the comment. If a typo slips somewhere, as in my case, you can fix it by clicking the first row of the comment. And obviously, if you change your mind about what you wrote, you can always click Delete Comment. It's important to note that in WorldServer, selection comments are converted to segment comments. On to the last part, which is quality assessment. You can assess the quality of a translation by clicking the Assessment tab. Here, click Show TQA and the Quality Assessment pane is displayed. To add the quality assessment, click Assess Quality and then start typing the details in the box. Then, select the appropriate category, subcategory if necessary, and severity. The categories and severities available are the ones from the quality model applied to your project in WorldServer. Now, you can unclaim the task again, complete the step, and download the target file. That was about it for this presentation. We hope that you'll enjoy the new SDL Online Editor, and we wish you happy translating. Goodbye!